Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 15.4 Beta 2 and iOS 15.3.1 have been out for a few days at this point. So I wanted to share some new changes or updates within the 15.4 Beta 2, as well as the overall experience of that and 15.3.1 overall. Now I've been using the beta full time on my 13 Pro Max and iPad Pro, and I have 15.3.1 on an iPhone 7, as many requested I show that device, as well as an iPhone 13 Pro. So we'll talk about the experience in a moment, but first let's talk about some changes or additional changes and features or updates in iOS 15.4 Beta 2. And the first thing is they've actually removed something, which was a bit of a surprise, but they removed a small feature or sort of setting, and that has to do with iCloud.com. So if we go into settings, tap on our name at the top, and then password and security, where we have legacy contact and things at the bottom, just like we have before. Prior to this, we actually had an option to access iCloud data on the web. It's no longer an option. You can't turn it on or off anymore. It's just something that's not there. So they've removed this for now. I'm not sure if it's going to come back, or they're just going to leave it on in general, since if you're subscribed to iCloud, you probably should maybe have the option to access it on the web if you want to. Graphics have been found in the iOS 15.4 code that confirm that Apple is adding support for captive Wi-Fi networks on different devices, which would allow them to be used in situation where there's maybe a web portal or an additional sign-up step to access Wi-Fi, maybe in a hotel or a place where you actually have to go to a sign-in page after you connect to their Wi-Fi network. So it looks like they're adding something like that very soon, once 15.4 is released. Also, it seems that they're adding something within news as well, a manage sports section. So that's something we haven't seen yet. Within news, maybe you go into following, you'll see different things that you're following, and you could manage sports as well. So that looks like they've added it. We're not seeing it physically yet, but we should see it in the release of 15.4. Now, something they've actually fixed in this update that's been confirmed is where you would maybe opt out of sharing voice recordings from Siri, it was actually sending them anyway. Beta 2 fixes this. So if you go into your settings, go to privacy, under privacy down at the bottom, under analytics and improvements, if you scroll down, you'll see it says share with app developers and then improve Siri and dictation. With improve Siri and dictation, when this was turned off, sometimes it was sharing those recordings. And I opt out of those things. I do allow a few different things such as health and activity, but most of these I turn off. And when they're off, they should be off. So this particular update fixes it. But again, that's part of being a beta tester. Sometimes things just don't work as intended. Also, there's one thing to know if you're using shortcuts with Apple Watch faces. So maybe if we go into shortcuts, you go into set up an Apple Watch face and you go to select a watch face to have it set automatically. You'll see here we can search for watch faces. So maybe we want Meridian, or we could look for the Unity watch face. It's just not showing any watch faces at all. So that's not really a feature, but it's something that's not working properly. So if you're seeing that in beta 2, that's probably why it seems to be not working. So we'll need to submit that in feedback. Within the code of beta 2, there is also mention of a new OS or operating system. Apple has long been rumored to be coming out with an augmented reality or maybe virtual reality headset, and it looks like they leaked the name of their operating system called Reality OS. It's actually within the code of the beta. So we don't know anything about it other than that there's a new OS that they're working on. That makes sense with their job hirings and more. So it looks like it's going to be called Reality OS, or that could just be a code name, but either way, they're definitely working on something. We may not see that until maybe a few years from now, but it's within the code, so it makes me think it's probably sooner rather than later. So I can't wait to see that. Hopefully we'll see that maybe at WWDC. Now, as far as the overall experience, let's first talk about 15.3.1. Many of you that are running it are saying that it's fairly stable and a very similar experience to iOS 15.3, and many people have messaged and told me the same, as well as on the YouTube community poll. There are a few issues with it, though. So one of those is quite a few people are mentioning that the device is being quite warm all the time, and this is an iPhone 7 in jet black, and it is quite warm. So this is a very warm phone right now. I booted it up, and it's really not doing anything. It's just sitting here, and it's also lost about, 25% of its battery since turning it on. So for whatever reason, it must be processing a lot of information in the background. Also, people are still continuing to see issues with CarPlay. So if you're plugging your phone in, or whether that be wireless CarPlay, many people are saying that it's very buggy. Now, that could be a couple different things, whether that be the iPhone or your manufacturer's stereo or device in the car handling that or managing that. But either way, it's definitely changed and less stable than it was before. However, it does work for many people, but it's still a problem for many as well. Also, many have said that there's odd sort of cellular drops with 15.3.1. I haven't seen this and I haven't heard any complaints directly from my family that's running it full time, but there are a few people saying that it drops for them with 15.3.1. Maybe it just doesn't jump onto cellular data once you leave Wi-Fi in your home. So some strange issues there. Now, battery life with 15.3.1 is mostly the same as 15.3, based off the comments in the YouTube community poll and information that some of you have sent me. Now, Cameron sent me his battery life full time since I've been using the beta full time. You'll see here that yesterday he had 5 hours and 49 minutes of screen on time, 55 minutes of screen off time. So that's doing pretty good. And then today, 3 hours and 59 minutes of screen on time, 19 minutes of screen off time. And he only used about a quarter of his battery. That's on an iPhone 13 Pro Max. So the day before, with almost 6 hours of screen on time, he used under 50% of his battery. So that's pretty typical what you would expect on a 13 Pro Max, where you would get about maybe 12 to 14 hours of screen on time. Very typical. It's working well for him. Not everyone, but a good amount of people say it's basically the same as 15.3. However, again, there are people that say it does get a bit warm, and that seems to be an issue for some. However, this phone is nice and cool, so it's kind of odd that they were booted up at the same time and one is warm, one is hot, but it's still processing in the background. As far as stability and speed on 15.3.1, most people say that it's quite stable. I haven't really had any issues with it, no reboots or resprings, and performance on this is okay. Many people again ask me to show the iPhone 7, and performance on this after booting up really wasn't that great. It was very stuttery after the initial boot up. So again, it's probably processing in the background, and it keeps wanting me to update my Apple ID on and off too. But you'll see as I open different applications, it stutters a little bit. I don't think this will be any different than 15.3 since it's just a minor update, but there's definitely some slowness here, at least on the initial boot up, and hopefully it improves. But right now it's kind of odd. On newer devices, I wouldn't expect that experience though. Beta 2 has been much better for me than Beta 1 with iOS 15.4. Many of you have told me the exact same thing. So Beta 2 fixes many issues people had with small bugs and glitches, and I've also had no random reboots or resprings like I did with Beta 1. Most people are saying they're having the same experience, so Apple definitely resolved a lot of issues in this update. Apps seem to be working as they should now. So for those of you that have banking apps or different apps that would just crash, I heard that with ESPN. Many people are saying that they seem to be working as they should without those apps needing to be updated. So Apple definitely improved the code in the background. Also, the overall experience is nice and smooth and fast. It doesn't seem to matter what device you're on, whether that's a ProMotion device or not, it seems to be nice and smooth. However, someone did mention that on 15.3.1, ProMotion seemed to maybe change or stutter a little bit depending on what you were in, whether that be settings or something else. So there's definitely something with that, and a reboot fixed it for them. So some odd bugs here and there, but with the beta, it seems to be mostly stable. With 15.3.1, there still will be a few things that should be resolved in the beta updates. Now, as far as overall battery life, we'll talk about that and then the remaining bugs with this update. Battery life, it seems to be okay. It's definitely better than beta 1 for me, but there's still some things using background activity that shouldn't be. So if we go into settings, go to my battery life, go to battery health, you'll see I'm at 100%. And those of you that have dropped battery health from installing an update or after installing an update, it's not caused by the update. It's just simply checking the battery health itself. So, or the battery capability of the physical battery. So that happens, all batteries degrade. So the update doesn't cause it. It's just rechecking it. And it could vary after a couple days as well. But battery life on this particular update hasn't been great for me. After 50% of usage yesterday, I only had 3 hours and 12 minutes of screen on time and 7 hours and 8 minutes of screen off time. So that's not very good battery life. However, you can see that music is using background activity, even though I'm not using it a whole lot. And that's typically because of that music bug still being there. Quite a few people have mentioned that the music bug is there, where it uses additional CPU power while you're streaming music if it's not downloaded, and in turn causes battery drain. So that seems to still be there. Hopefully they fix it in a future update, or at least address that they've fixed it. It's something that's causing a lot of sort of excessive battery drain. Also, you'll see apps using background activity that shouldn't be. So hopefully they'll fix that in future updates. However, a few others of you have had better battery life than me. So if we take a look at the battery life here, this is from Abhishek. This is on an iPhone 11 Pro Max. He had 7 hours and 17 minutes of screen on time with 20 minutes of screen off time and used about 60 or 75% of his battery. Matthew sent in his battery on an iPhone 13 as well and had 6 hours and 25 minutes of screen on time and 28 minutes of screen off time using about 60% of his battery, which is quite good on an iPhone 13. On the iPad, though, it's a different story for me with the betas. With the iPad, it seems like I'm constantly charging the battery. So you'll see I'm only at 23%, and I used it yesterday some. And if we go over to settings, go to battery, give it just a moment, there's an odd bug here where it says last charged Thursday at 1:18 p.m. Well, it's been charged since then, and it's kind of odd that it's sort of giving me these odd times where it's charged. Typically, I'll charge it every day or so, or every other day. So if we go back maybe to a day or so ago on Friday, I only had 2 hours and 5 minutes of screen on time, 25 minutes of screen off time. And typically after regular usage, I'm only getting about 5 hours of screen on time. This is not really good for this device. I should be getting closer to 10. And you'll see Find Mine is using 42% of my background activity. I'm not even using that app. So even if someone's looking to see where you are, it should be using the device that's turned on, not my iPad. So if I'm using my phone, also Siri used 13% of my battery, and Home did as well, which again, shouldn't be using background activity. So these are all bugs within the OS. However, the iPad experience is fine. I really haven't had a single bug other than the battery issues. Also, many others have told me Siri is using different background activity from them as well. So definitely an odd bug with them. However, there has not been a mention of green or red tint in some time. So whether people are just dealing with it and know that it's an issue, or it's maybe gone away, Apple has not addressed it specifically. I haven't seen it in quite some time from a lot of people. So I'd love to hear from you if you're still having green tint on maybe a 12 Pro Max, maybe the red tint on a 13 Pro Max, things like that. I'd love to hear from you in the comments below about that. Now, also the storage bug seems to be a big issue for quite a few people. While that doesn't affect functionality of the device, it's more of an annoyance than anything else. However, I thought they fixed it on 15.3.1, but quite a few people told me that it's still happening to them where it just won't load. So if we go into iPhone storage, you'll see here it loaded on the iPhone 7. It's still loading. If we check on beta 2, we'll go to iPhone storage. It seems to load pretty quickly for me. It loaded very quickly on the iPhone 7. That's the first time I've opened it on the iPhone 7 as well. So on 13 or 15.3.1, it's working fine. On 15.4 beta 2, fine for me as well, but not everyone is experiencing that. Seems to be okay. System data is taking a bit to fill in beta 2. But on the public version, it seems to be much better. Maybe they're still working on it at this point. One other person mentioned that they have an issue with charging, where it wasn't working properly and randomly stops charging, whether that be on an iPhone or iPad. So they thought maybe it was due to third-party chargers, similar to what we had with the Apple Watch, but I haven't experienced that, and I've only heard that from one person, but I thought I'd mention it since if that is an issue, Apple will need to be made aware of it through the feedback app. So if you're having that issue, definitely let me know in the comments below and make sure you report it in feedback. Now, as far as when to expect iOS 15.4 beta 3 and a final release, I would say at this point, you can expect it probably next week where we would have beta 3. However, if we're still on a 2 week cycle, it could be maybe the week of the 20th. So we'll have to wait and see by Tuesday or Wednesday whether or not we have that update, with a final update probably releasing sometime in the second week of March, around March 8th. Many expect Apple to announce an event on March 8th where we would have new iPads, maybe an iPhone SE Generation 3, and we would have that update released maybe after the event or the day after the event. That's typically what Apple would do. So we can expect at least another beta with a release candidate and then a final release. That's typically what Apple does. Now, also, if you're wondering if you should install 15.3.1, I definitely would install that if you haven't already and you want to be on a public version. It has the latest security updates. And also, someone asked me, if you're on iOS 14, will you have those security updates? And the answer is Apple's no longer updating iOS 14. So you're still vulnerable to those security vulnerabilities if you're not on the latest version of 15. Also, you're missing out on a couple hundred feature changes as well. As far as 15.4 Beta 2, if you want to try it out so you can use your Face ID with a mask without using an Apple Watch, you can do that, but just be aware there are still a few bugs in here. It's much more stable than Beta 1, but just be aware that it could have some issues. Now let's take a look at the YouTube community poll and take a look at what you had to say. We'll take a look at maybe 5 or 10 comments. Let's refresh here. And I've read every one of these comments before making the video. And on 15.4 Beta 2, you'll see that we have 13,000 votes, at least at the time of this video, with 212 comments. 19% of you are on Beta 2, 62% of you are on 15.3.1, and 12% of you are on 15.3 or older. 3% of you are on 14.8.1, and 5% are either on iOS 12 or older versions, as well as Android. When it comes to 15.3.1, I actually only made this live a couple hours ago, but this particular update seems to be great according to 61% of you. 5% say it's terrible, 13% say it's okay but has some bugs, 9% are using the betas, which makes sense based off of this here, and 13% of you are using something else. Now let's take a look at a few comments from each of these. Joseph W. says, iOS 15.3.1 seems the same as 15.3 on my iPhone 13 Pro, and I would expect that. Performance and battery life have been consistent and remain the same since 15.3, and 120 Hz feels smooth in 15.3.1. David Friedman says, been running it on my iPhone 13, and battery life and performance has been great. Also, Siddhartha Sakia, hopefully I'm saying that properly, the storage bug is still there. Hassan Al-Hadari said, I have updated directly after the release of 15.3.1. In fact, nothing changed in my mobiles, 12 Pro and 10S Max. Performance or the battery life, it's perfect for me. T-Man said, no new issues found on my iPhone 11. Battery's good, or as good as it can be at 86%, waiting for iPhone 14. Screen's good, no weird tint. Cameras are good, no apps are acting unusually or closing. Again, no new issues. Let's take a look at the other poll where we have 15.4 Beta 2. Again, we'll sort and see what you had to say. Jeremy Lee said, using iPad Pro 11-inch second gen, I've been experiencing charging issues since Beta 1. It randomly stops charging. I think it's related to the multi-port gallium nitride chargers. Hope Apple fixes this in the future. And I think this might be the second person I've seen mention this as well, so hopefully they will fix that. Junior Brito said, hi Aaron, I'm on iOS 15.4 Beta 2, and the big problem I'm having now is Face ID intermittently works. Besides that, everything else looks fine. So again, for those of you wanting to try this update out, you may want to hold off just as sometimes things don't work properly. Archie said, very stable so far. Third-party apps working fine and smooth as ever with ProMotion. Haven't found any bugs. Not so sure how good battery is though. Gadget Gamer said, running iOS 15.4 Beta 2 here, and so far, not bad. Battery seems decent. However, Safari sometimes randomly goes back to an old search with no way of going back. Other than that, everything is good for a beta. Abhishek Lamba said, iOS 15.4 Beta 2 is quite stable on my iPhone 11 Pro Max. It is far better than Beta 1 battery. I wish it could be a little more sometimes. There are stutters here and there, but that's okay. The Cool Gamer 60, iPhone XS Max on Beta 2, the battery seems to drain a lot faster now for some reason, but other than that, no bugs or slowdown. Daniel Adesso said, on iOS 15.4 Beta 2, iPhone 13 is freezing, rebooting, acting sluggish, storage doesn't want to load, not good at all. Trinivius Manifi said, pretty good so far, not too many bugs I can notice, I'm running the beta on my iPhone 12 Pro Max. Matt Barton said, iOS 15.4 Beta 2 on an iPhone 13 Pro have a settings bug where upon entering settings and making a selection, a gray screen with settings appears. Closing settings, then reopening clears this. Battery life is not as good as the previous beta. Vincent says, I'm using iPhone 12 Pro on 15.4 Beta 2. Most of the apps are working. Some apps, like the banking app, crash on me. Battery is very good. My screen on time is estimated about 7 to 8 hours with 91% battery health. So far, this update has been very smooth. And so that's everything with iOS 15.4 Beta 2 and iOS 15.3.1. Again, I wouldn't hesitate to update to 15.3.1, but you may want to hold off if you're on the betas or wanting to try out the betas, as they still could be quite buggy. But either way, they seem to be pretty solid compared to the previous beta. And I think it'll be great once we get beta 3, a release candidate, and a final release where we'll have those new emoji and everything else. So I'm looking forward to that. And of course, iOS 16, once that's released, that won't be until September, but we'll see it for the first time in June. So I really look forward to that. Hopefully we'll get a new control center design, as I've talked about last year, as well as maybe some new icons and more. It seems like we're due for quite a few changes, so I'm hoping we see something like that. But if you found anything else in 15.4 Beta 2, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.